Thank you to Manus for sponsoring this video and making it happen. Click the link in the description to go to Manus and start building yourself. A lot of people are calling Manus the best AI agent out there because of its combination of skills of research and web app building. Today, I'm going to treat Manus like my co-founder at No Code MBA and have it do tasks that are really on my to-do list. At the end of the video, I'm going to give you my honest opinion of whether I think it's actually good or if you might want to use other tools. The first thing that I want to do is I've been meaning for a while to do a better job of tracking sponsorships and partnerships with No Code MBA. Right now, everything lives in a Google spreadsheet, which works, but it could be more organized. So the first thing we're going to do is testing Manus's ability to build full stack applications. So the prompt I'm doing is to build a CRM web app that I can use to manage my YouTube sponsorship requests. Say I am a YouTuber, and I want to track info about the sponsor, what the sponsorship is, how much it is, type of payment, and whether payment is made. And then maybe also track whether video is published. So we're going to go ahead and send this off and let Manus start working on it. Now, one of my favorite things about Manus is it does a really good job at multi-tracking agentic work. So this is going to start working, but then I can go over here and do a new task, and we can come back to that later on. So we're going to just batch work together and then see how it all unfolds as Manus starts completing it. The next task is going to be more of a research-based task. Please research YouTube for videos in the last month in the AI tool space that have outperformed based on the views of the video and the channel size. My YouTube channel is No Code MBA, so I'd like to use this research to understand what topics are trending and what I should create videos on. So again, we're just going to go ahead and send this off, and we can use the adaptive agent. I don't need to add anything else for now. We're just going to start with that and send it off. So this is going to be more of a research agent to help me come up with some ideas of YouTube videos that I should be creating in the future. So while it's doing that research task for me, let's go ahead and do another tab, and I'm going to spin up another researcher. So the prompt here I'm going to give is to research AI and no-code newsletters and give me 20 advertisers who have advertised in those newsletters in the last month. So basically, I would love to have some more advertisers in the No-Code MBA newsletter, which is sent out weekly. And one great way to do that is to see who else is advertising in similar newsletters and then reach out to those people to offer ad slots. So I'm going to send this off as well and see how it does on that research. So while it's doing that, why don't we jump back into the CRM and see what's happening over here. So looks like it's still working. It's just building it out. It's creating a project plan. This is something that I think is cool about Manus is that it does everything at once. And this is also new to the new Manus 1.5 update that they created. So now it can build full stack web apps and also do the research that it's doing over here. So it can do all of it at once. So now we're going to send off another prompt. This is going to be, again, kind of a researcher, but maybe a little bit more of a brainstorming session. So I wanted to go to No Code MBA's website and give me feedback on the homepage. What copy could be improved? How can I better position the site to convert more people to want to sign up for our courses? So let's send that off. And then it looks like we have a notification over here in the CRM. So it looks like it might be done. Let's see. It says it's ready. I've built a complete web app with a database-backed system. The app features a dark theme dashboard where I can add, edit, and delete sponsorships, track payment status and video publication, all in one. And next steps could be adding filtering, dashboard analytics, due dates, and reminders as well. So this is pretty cool. Let's test it out. Let's add a sponsor. So let's say, you know, someone reaches out, they're going to do it. So let's say it's Manus. And I guess the company could be Manus as well. This could be the name of the contact. I guess it depends on how you want to handle that. So let's just whatever, email@manus.com. I'm going to leave phone blank. So it could be, let's say it's a dedicated video. Say they're paying me $1 and payment up front. And let's say no other notes. Video publishes now. So let's create that. And now we have this nice little dashboard here. Manus dedicated video up front, unpaid. If I click on that, it goes to paid. That's nice. If I click on that, it goes to published. It's also just like a nice design. I think it did a cool job. Just, I want to see what this looks like with more data, and I don't want to just add them all in manually right now. So I'm going to say, can you just add in like 10 dummy data rows? So that way we can look at it with some more data and see if we want to make any other changes. It looks like we can jump back in real quick to this one. So it looks like Manus is going to No Code MBA, and we can actually view Manus's computer. So it's using its own browser to actually read it. And then it's creating its own file of feedback, and just maybe it's also just creating a file of the current structure and then feedback. But it's cool. You can see it's like actually browsing the site. So that's pretty cool. So that's going on over here. Still doing research on the AI newsletters to try and get us people there. Let's see, trending AI topics. Let's see what it's doing. It looks like it's browsing YouTube, literally clicking on elements, doing research, analyzing performance relative to channel size. So it's doing all that research. We'll see what it actually comes up with. I'm interested. And maybe I should have been more specific about AI tools. I think I'm going to actually do that. And this is something you can do. I'm kind of reading what it's doing. I'm seeing it searching like AI video generator, which isn't as much what I want. So I'm going to stop it. We're just going to pause. I'm going to say, just to clarify, by AI tools, I'm most interested in AI app builders. So let's send that off. Okay, so it looks like it's finished with its research. It says it researched Superhuman, TLDR AI, Benzbytes, and the Neuron, all of which have a lot of subscribers. And it looks like it did find some advertisers. And it also gives me some priorities based on who is advertising most recently. And it created this document here. So I can see HubSpot, Notion, Salesforce, Calendly. I wonder where it got this contact information from. I guess it might have just like searched their website. So we can see recent sponsorships, where it was in, Salesforce, Calendly, Masterworks, Google. Interesting. Yeah, but okay, it did come up with a lot of them. I want to do a little bit more with this. I'm going to say, please put the data in a spreadsheet for easier review. Also, please include the newsletter link/ad copy that was used, or ad copy that was used. So I want to know like how they advertised, and then it would also be better to be a spreadsheet instead of a document there. So, all right, looks like we're starting to get some work back from our agents here. So let's see. All right, so it did create some data. And then also just to show you what's cool is this is all in the database. Like it just added it to the database. So this is just all built into Netus. So go back to the preview. So it created some data. So I think what would be helpful is I want to see dates as well. I don't know if I asked for that at first, but let's add publish dates as well as status recorded, for example. And I'd also like to be able to see it in a Trello format because I want to be able to just visualize it a little bit easier. So yeah, so let's send that out and then go back to our other tasks and see what's happening. So here on the YouTube research, it's just refocusing it on AI app builders specifically. And then over here on the homepage feedback. Okay, it looks like the homepage feedback is actually done. So let me click into this and check it out. So it's saying maybe update it to be a little bit more inclusive of other no-code use cases. Just some better copy improvements here, potentially. So specific copywriting positioning recommendations. So that's kind of what I want. So proposed changes, your idea is brought to life, no-code required. I like that idea actually a lot. Stop dreaming, start building. I'm like the benefit-driven. That I actually really like. Maybe I'll change my homepage based on that feedback. Let's see. Instead of leading with the tools, lead with the outcome. So yeah, talk more about what you'll achieve. I like that as well. I think that makes a lot of sense. And then, you know, something else you could do is say, hey, look into competitor research and include that. Actually, why don't we do that? Why don't we say, this is great. And you also do some competitor research for some more ideas. So we'll send that up. So here we're in the newsletter. It looks like it created a spreadsheet for us. So let's open this up. And I can open it up here. And you can also download it, just download the file, but also download it to Google Drive as well. So yeah, it now has, we have the list of 25. We can see what they do, the newsletter that it was advertised in, the newsletter URL. So it looks like some of them are not giving us the exact URL. Some of them it's coming from a database, but some of them, like this one, like in TLDR AI, it looks like it's just like getting the actual newsletter. So if I can even click on it, this was the newsletter from yesterday. And we can see, is there a sponsor? It's a pretty long newsletter. Let's search for sponsor. Yeah, okay. 100 prompts for Notion agents. That was a sponsor. And then cut the cost of IT complexity and AW Bedrocks. Three sponsors, actually. And yeah, it got two of them. So I don't know why it didn't get three, but that's cool. It's got 11 labs and IBM. So it got both of those, which is really cool. And then this one, it looks like it also got the from today, on Ben's Bytes. I got the advertisers and also got TLDR from today as well. So that's actually great. That's really, really good. I think like actually what could be interesting is having it check every day for new advertisers. So maybe that's what I'm going to do next. Turn this into like a little bit more of an automation. Let me exit out and I'll say, this is great. Could you run the same automation every day to check for new leads? So we're going to come back to that. And we're actually getting a lot done. I'm getting more done than I thought in this video. So, okay, it says, yes, it can do that. It's going to create a schedule task that can check the major newsletters, identify new advertisers, update it, and send me a summary. So it's going to basically turn this, create this recurring lead generation automation. I'm going to accept that and turn it on. And it's creating a scheduled task. And I'm going to show you later where, so we can see that here is the scheduled task. And if you go here, you can view all scheduled tasks. So it's here in your settings. So now I have the scheduled task going at daily at 9 a.m. I should be able to edit that and say, actually, maybe I want to make sure the newsletter gets out. So daily at 11 a.m., for example. But you could do anything. I could say 10:45 and I'll click save. And there we go. So we have that done. I think that's in a really good spot now. I really like this idea of like thinking about these automations that you can do, especially with research or things that change every day. That's really cool. So here we're back in the YouTube research and let's see what the recommendations are. So basically it found some outliers. Google AI Studio is a breakout star. Multiple videos achieved 130K. It's funny because I actually created a video on Google AI Studio that did do very well. Tool comparisons do well and free alternatives are also doing well. And it has some standouts here. And yeah, that's actually really interesting. So immediate opportunities, Google AI Studio, which is funny because again, I did that already. So it's funny that it suggested it and it did work well for me. Lovable versus bold versus cursor. And then we can even open this app. Then it comes up with some kind of an executive summary report. And yeah, it's turning it into kind of giving me some analysis, the top performing creators and specific ideas. So that's really cool. So I'm actually going to say I want to do the same thing. I want this maybe not daily, but I'd love a weekly update on trending videos. Can we do our schedule? So we're going to do this on a schedule too. And now I'm going to have an agent that's like building this report for me on a weekly basis. Okay, so while that's happening, let's jump back in to, let's jump into the app because then we can get back to some of the research stuff. So, okay. So now we have a status field with 7 stages. We have so we can see negotiating, confirmed, reported, editing, scheduled, published, and completed. And this is in that kind of Trello board style, but you can also view it as a table as well. And then the published date as well. So that's great. We can add a sponsorship. Yeah, this is really nice. I think I might end up using this. I'm going to have to see and upload all my like current backlog of leads, but this could be really great. And a couple ideas, revenue analytics, calendar view, drag and drop cards. Actually, yeah, let's do drag and drop cards. I think that would be really helpful. So let's add drag and drop cards. Okay, so we'll let it do that. We're going to jump back in real quick. So just confirming we have our weekly schedule for AI building trends on YouTube. So that's done. And then we're going to go real quick to our competitive analysis because I asked it to do some competitive analysis here for us. And if we go down, we can see it looked up NoCode.tech, BuildCamp, and NoCode Institute. All are really great companies and doing great work. So major insights, AI coding pivot, and that's what I'm doing as well with NoCode MBA. The career outcomes win. That's interesting in that they're actually placing people into jobs. That's not what I'm doing. But still, for this is, you know, these types of research tasks, like it could be helpful to have it do this maybe on like more of a monthly basis to do some competitive research and see what other people are doing in the space. Okay, so last one, let's just have it finish up this drag and drop Trello board. All right, so it says it's live, so let's try it out. Can I drag these cards over? And yeah, looks like it's all working correctly now. So pretty cool. Hope that you enjoyed this video with me using an army of agents to actually get real work done. These genuinely were things on my to-do list that I was just able to knock out here with Manus. Click the link in the description to go to Manus. Thank you so much to Manus for making this possible. And click the link to let them know that you really appreciated this video. And if it's something that you could see yourself using, definitely check it out. Leave a comment to let me know what you think of this video. Do you want me to do more videos like this in the future? And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.